What's going on, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Now, today, we've got the most successful cricket teams in ODI by ICC. Well, I was going to say ICC. Yeah, that works too. Rankings from 2002 to 2020. So it's an 18-year span, if you didn't know. Crazy enough, you know, not trying to expose my age, but I was born in 2002. I'm not going to tell you where. I might have said it in a video before, but look, I'm a 2002 baby. Again, drop what year, drop what year, you know, you were born in. Secondly, I have to address it's, my face cam's in a weird position because, look, there's so much shit going on the left side and then the years down here and I couldn't, you know, put it on either bottom side. So it's in the fucking middle of the screen. Just, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You know, you have to deal with it for now, just for this video and for these sort of videos. But hey, check it out. I just woke up, hence why I'm wearing the same outfits as probably yesterday's video or the day before. Okay. It's very weird to see Kenya on a list. I don't know who they would have beaten. Zimbabwe? That's before 2002, I was just, you know, I was born already. So, you know, I wasn't ready to strap on the old pads and fucking head into war for Zimbabwe just yet. I didn't know Pakistan were that good early on with ODIs. I knew they were like a top four team, but I honestly thought it would have been a fourth max, not third or second. England were garbage. New Zealand were garbage. Come on, Zimbabwe. Go. No, go up. Damn it. New Zealand, India. All right, here come India. Surprisingly, Kenya played 2003 World Cup semi. What? What? Kenya played a World Cup semi-final against fucking who? Who that? Okay, I'm just... Where is Kenya? I haven't heard of Kenya playing cricket since fucking 1922, I swear. Who led Australia? That's Ricky Ponting, right? Nice. Two World Cups and two... I'm going to turn this background sound down. It's fucking pissing me off now. Australia still heavily on top. What we like to see, people. England. Hey, and what we love to see even more... England are fucking trash. No, 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 England, stop. Damn, what happened? Why did all these teams just suddenly say, look, we don't feel like winning anymore? Bro, Kenya and Zimbabwe are just down terrible. Zimbabwe, stop. Jesus Christ. Have we always been the number one team? I feel like in recent years, we've been like third and shit. I remember like the period, like 2016, 2017, wasn't England like the best or something? Oh, Kenya, no! So that's where Kenya went out of the international ODI rankings in 2005. And then Bangladesh came in, which is, I mean, they're much better. When did Afghanistan come in? Imagine they get rid of Zimbabwe, unfortunately. South Africa. That was such a strong side. Now they're just not great. And yes, people, since I just woke up, coffee. I tell you what, I'm fucking half asleep right now. I'm just trying to focus on the words on the screen in front of me. New Zealand, shit. South Africa's coming hard, Australia, go! Get some wins. Where's Zimbabwe going? No! Zimbabwe, stay with me. Stay with me. Graham Smith. I don't know if you guys can read the facts. I don't think my face cam's blocking it. But Graham Smith, captain South Africa. No one fucking cares. He kept him for a while, though. I'll give him that. Hey, there's Dad! Oh, my face cam might be blocking my dad. Hey, they spelt my last name wrong! Michael Clark's meant to have an E on the end. Look, I'm sorry, people, but that's just... That's Dad right there. I mean, I don't know. Can you see my face next to his? Pretty fucking identical, I tell you that. Ireland are in the picture now. What the fuck? Where'd Zimbabwe go? Oh, Zimbabwe fell out? Look at England. They're still shit. Really warms my soul to know that they've been shit. Sri Lanka, come on. Ireland, no, where are you going? Hey, just a little fun fact, not that anyone cares, but I am half Irish. Or not half, a quarter. Just a little fun fact for you. So 25% of me is Irish. So I do have a soft spot for Ireland. You know, I like to keep up with some, you know, cricket-wise Ireland do. I remember watching a series against Afghanistan like a few years ago. Gee, was that a nightmare to watch because Ireland got bowled out for like 90 and then like 30, so it wasn't great. Remember when they beat England or something at like one test match at Lords or something, wasn't it? That was crazy. Ireland, you slowly step. Jeez, Australia is just. But here comes England. Shit! England are top. Oh, good, India. Well done. Oh, good. Oh, they're going down even more. They suck. Jesus Christ. Zimbabwe's back into the picture, people. Don't you worry. Zimbabwe is back. This is when I joined. I would have only been about 8 or 7 at this time, but I joined the board. They said, look, mate, we're going to give you some throwdowns in the nets. And look, I just... Oh, now we're out. Never mind. I wasn't here at this point, don't I? Oh, no, I just joined now. Yeah, it's my bad. Australia's still holding on. India, fuck off. I like you, India, but don't go in front of Aussie right now. I need this for my heart and my soul. Go. Come on, we want to see Zimbabwe get off the bottom. Go, Zimbabwe. Go, 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 go. It's slowing. It's still going. Oh, no. Oh, it's a real tussle. I don't give a shit about what's going on in the top half. I care what's going on down the bottom with Ireland and fucking Zimbabwe. It's more gripping. Australia still on top. South Africa. How's Sri Lanka? I don't remember them being such a one day. I guess with Lasith Malinga and Kusail Mendes. I guess they were actually quite good. Now that I think about it. This background music's not it, to be honest. Can you hear that? It's my washing machine, people. If you could hear that little beeping in the background, that's my washing machine. It's telling me to get off my ass and go and get it, which is probably not going to happen. Australia, we're still on top. We haven't moved once from the top Australia. This is fucking nuts. We've been really the most, like, dominant one-day force. Oh, fuck it. And now we're down to fourth? I shouldn't have said anything. Damn it. Whoa, whoa. Look what's happening on the bottom of your screen. New Zealand are down tremendously. They are second last. New Zealand in 2012 were just down tremendously. They were second last. India's back on top. MS Dhoni captain India in 200 ODIs. Well, fucking Jesus. How many did Ricky Ponting captain? Wouldn't have been that many though. But Australia, we're going. Go, go Australia. Go, 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 go. Bangladesh, look at all the boys down the bottom. Zimbabwe, it's good to see him back out there. He's the only captain in history to win all ICC trophies. Well, unfortunately, that's not true anymore because the new Test Championship trophy, he hasn't won that. So, I guess a new record's been set. Who will be the first captain to win all three of those? Well, to win the Test Championship, T20, and then one day. I want to see Zimbabwe get off the bottom. Sri Lanka, still surprising me, to be honest. Pakistan. New Zealand have been just not great, have they? In one-day matches, I thought, you know, Brendan McCullum, you know, Kane Williamson, surely they had a good fucking one-day squad. Clearly not. Where are we? Third. These graphs. I wish they were given more facts on the side. Here we go. Steve Smith captained Australia from 2015 to 2018 in ODI. He did, and was actually quite a good captain. Until he was given a year ban, and look, I'm not going to get into that. Oh. I'm tired, people, I'm tired. That's when we won the World Cup, 2015. Well, clearly the best team. Clearly, I mean, look at the graph. We've got the fucking graph right in front of us, people. What month did we win it? I thought it was like November. Afghanistan, there they are. Oh, but it came... At what cost did it come out of Zimbabwe? Oh, well, they were quite good. I remember I think back end of 2018, they got on a streak of where they won about like 3 or 4 ODIs in a row. Against like West Indies, I think, but still, not bad. Jeez, we're still the best. New Zealand finally doing something. Where's India? Fourth. It's okay. South Africa's better than us in 2017? What the fuck? Okay. Alright, I just have to bring up something. I'm sure everyone here knows what an olive is. Like, the food, I don't know, I have to show you what eating looks like, but an olive. Bangladesh's logo looks like an olive. I'm sorry, it looks like the green, and then it's got that little red stuff inside. It depends what sort of olives you get, but those are the popular ones in Australia. So, look. Agree or not? Let me know. And who likes olives? Because olives, I do like them. Virat Kohli is current. Yeah, he is. Only 2017 he became captain. That's surprising. I thought it was like at least a year earlier, but there you go. Afghanistan back in the picture. Where's Zimbabwe? New Zealand on top. No. Where's Australia? Who the fuck's that? Owen Morgan? Is it? Yeah, I think so. Damn, we're down tremendously under Pakistan. Oh, this is when the ban hits, I want to say. Because I remember we just became absolute dog shit when fucking Smith and Warner went out. Mm-mm. Yummy, yummy caffeine. Owen Morgan led England to the World Cup. Look, he may have led them, but he wasn't their best player, was he? I didn't think so. I thought fucking... as much as I hate to say it, I guess that red hair fucking spastic looking fucking motherfucking F. Ben Stokes motherfucking looking stupid looking motherfucking stupid fucking piece of shit looking fucking motherfucker was probably their best player. Whoa, I guess that's going to cap it off. I kind of got distracted talking shit about Ben Stokes, which, look, is always a happy thing to do. If you did make it this far to the video, comment hashtag F. Ben Stokes. You know what the hashtag is. Get around it. Hey, we're building our channel back up. We're grinding harder than ever. We're back on the YouTube grind. I'm going to stick to my word. I'm going to, do my very best to make this channel get big again. Share it with your goldfish. Share it with your mum, your nan, your dad, your brother, your sister. I was going to say something, but it's probably not of the terms of service for YouTube, so I'll probably get deleted. Like, comment, subscribe, all that shit. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in the next one.